Hi, welcome to the mapp AlarmX tutorial part 5. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to display alarms in a MapView HMI application quickly and easily using widgets. A MapView visualization object has already been added to this project, as you can see here. The component mp AlarmX core has already been added to the init subroutine and configured as it was in part 1 of the mapp AlarmX tutorial. The core element of the alarm list, the alarm list widget, is added to the editor via drag and drop and placed on the content. To establish a connection to the mapAlarmX component, maplink gAlarmX core must be connected to the property mplink. Next, we have to define which information should be displayed in the alarm list. We want to see the timestamp of the alarm message, and the alarm state, so we'll need to add the alarm list item widget 3 times. For each alarm list item widget, we'll then use the property column type to define which information should be displayed. The first column should contain the timestamp, so here we'll select timestamp. The second column should contain the alarm message. This is already selected as the type. The third column should contain the alarm state, so here we'll select state. Finally, we need to add the MP server library. After the changes have been downloaded onto the controller, the HMI application can be opened via the web browser. If an alarm is activated using the user alarm variable, like in part 1 of the mapAlarmX tutorial, it shows up in the alarm list. As you can see, it's very easy to display an alarm list using widgets. Thanks for watching.